In the year 1984, a man named Rick Rubin and Russell Simmons founded a record label known as Def Jam Recordings. This record label would go on to sign many of the biggest names in hip-hop and R&B throughout history, still signing on many artists to this day. And in the early 2000s, a small indie company known as Electronic Arts decided, hey, we should make a wrestling game, but we can't really base it off the WWE because that's not really owned by us and they already are doing their own thing with other game companies. So what do we do? Well, someone in that meeting basically was like, hey, I know a little record label that we could base this off of. And so the game Def Jam Vendetta was born, a wrestling game / fighting game based off the record label and the artists signed to it. If you've ever wanted to play as a late 90s, early 2000s hip-hop R&B artist and beat the shit out of other late 90s, early 2000s hip-hop R&B artists, well, this is right up your alley. Okay. EA Sports. God damn, dude.
Used to be, you wanted to make yourself known. You'd prove your worth as a street fighter or hustler. We don't fight out in the streets no more. We're organized now. We too gangster for the garden, so we've taken it underground. Inside. I'm a businessman, and this is my business.
If you want to know whose voice you're hearing right now, that's Christopher Judge, also known as the voice of Kratos in the God of War games nowadays. So now whenever I get around to playing Ragnarok, I'm just going to be quoting D-Mob the entire time.
I lay down for no man. You want to take what's mine. You gotta beat me, but nobody ever beats me.
I'm just gonna say that to Atreus every time. Anyways, welcome to Def Jam Vendetta. This is, my controller's not connected because I'm an asshole. Let the copyright journey begin. So this is Def Jam Vendetta. I did have a practice file just to make sure this would work, so we'll put in a new one and we'll play a little bit of the story mode here. How about that? Okay, where we need? Who do we want to play as? My God, do I want to play as the fat guy? This guy's most balanced, but like, I'm gonna go with the fat guy just because I've never played as this guy before when playing this game. In too deep, need your fists. Gross. That's all I would text back. Look at those hot dog fingers. What is this, Kingdom Hearts? It's copyright hell up in here. Sorry for the ads, inevitably. Oh, we're versing Pee-wee? Man looks like he has a very nice temperament. I'm sorry, I don't actually know how to play. I haven't played this in a long time. I don't even look like a fighter. I look like somebody who just wandered in off the street. You're scratching your ass in front of me. Oh my God. Okay, fine, sure. Yep. I'm gonna throw you this time. How about that? My guy, I'm still remembering how to play this, so don't hold it against me. So, the point, he's too fat. I can't do it. There we go. The point of Def Jam is to get your opponent's health into danger, and then you have to perform a finisher on them. But you can't perform a finisher unless you're blazoned. And the only way to get them blazoned is if we get that little blue meter down there filled up. And at the current moment, we're close, but we're not quite there yet. It's because the higher it is, the faster it deteriorates. You just gotta be like on a freaking roll, baby. to get it. You know what I'm saying? You can also pin your opponent, get the count going, and that is another way to eliminate them. You can also just break one of their limbs, too. I'm sorry. Did I, like, break the supersonic sound barrier because I hit him and then heard it, like, 2 seconds later? We can also spend some money to raise our stats here, and obviously our speed is total ass, so we'll do that. Drake? That doesn't look like Drake. I know Drake, and that's not Drake. I'm sorry, what? This is a semifinal? We're in a tournament? I was not told I was in a tournament. It's just opening move, giant bitch slap. Toss him. Man, the controls suck. I'm gonna tell you that right now. Like, whether you're playing this on a GameCube or on a freaking ColecoVision, like, it does not matter. Your controls are straight doo-doo. Oh, man. Okay. My man's got moves. I'm gonna give him a noogie. Rope breaks give him, like, a... Rope breaks give him a ton of, like... Dude. A ton of, influence, I guess I'll call it. I don't know what that mirror's official name actually is. Stop throwing me! How do I prevent that from happening? My man's over here in danger and kicking my ass. He's also blazing. Well, he could be. Come here. Let's see if I can pin him. Yep, got him. Dang! I normally don't win with pins because, they suck, but also because I think you just get a less rating overall, fight-wise. It's much better if you go blazing and then do a finisher on them. Charisma, I know, increases, like, your influence with the crowd, so, like, you can go blazing faster earlier. Defense might also be nice, because we're getting our dick kicked in. Here's where I would sing a Scarface song if I knew one. In Cold Blood, there's a Scarface song. Well, you're about to get your ass beat. You think they had to get his ass in a recording studio and be like, you gotta say one line, my guy, and it's, you're about to get your ass beat. My guy, you suck. You also did not dress for the occasion. Clearly you have to be dressed like you're about to go work at a frickin' train yard, like me. I don't want to do this to you, Scarface. Wow! Oh! I legitimately don't believe that you can move that fast, man. There's no way. Bam. I'm crazy. All right, come here. Oh my god, I'm Donkey Kong. There's no way. No way my man would flip and do two flips in the air. See, a lot more money for getting that finisher.
Damn, Playboy. Where'd you learn to move like that?
Yeah, you keep fighting like that, my money troubles are over.
I physically resemble a tater tot. There is no way that you're anyway, shape or form looking at the way I'm moving and going like, damn.
Where are you going? You don't want to get mixed up with that again. Look, here's the story. Angel is with Demop now.
Angel's with Kratos now. The end. You are not a god of war. No, I don't want to see it. Good work against Face last night. I'm not sure he likes being called Face. Word's out that you're back. You better get into shape if you want to fight the big money. I don't want to fight money. Or I'm up against these chumps while I try to set you up with a feature bout. Who's chumps? What? I'm gonna level my speed like no one's business. That way I'm just the fastest dude on the planet. Sketch, Roughneck, Steel, and Razor. Looks like a fine group of gentlemen with whom I'd like to share a drink with. What am I doing? Okay, of the two of us, I'm the more worrisome one. with those two intros. Like, that's cause for concern that I'm sitting there beating the shit out of myself. I'm kicking my own ass before the fight. I'm like, this dude needs a handicap. I like how I turned that from going, like, I'm crazy to I'm just overconfident as fuck. And tossed. These move names are just absolutely ridiculous. Excuse me? How did that happen? And toss. Get a couple of steps in. You know, gotta finish my exercise rings. Now, if you do a blazing move on somebody who's not in danger, it won't actually finish them. It'll just do a ton of damage to them, which... you can see why that would be a problem. So they have to be in danger, and you have to get a finisher on them. And I don't remember if power moves are in this game or not. Tight moves. There's like power moves in the sequel, and like you can actually finish fights with those too. I thought you never wanted to see me again. Well, you and your skank girlfriend deserve each other. Now get the hell out of here before you cause trouble for both of us. I like how we're at defjam.com, like as if we are a part of said record label conglomerate. And go for Roughneck. Roughneck, who looks like a redneck, who may or may not have a racial bias within this field, shall we say. I think there's a clear racial bias. Look, I know I'm your worst nightmare, somebody who's Asian and fat, but oh, you gotta work with me, my guy. You can't be kicking me in the face. This will be in the national news tomorrow. Or will it? Don't be tossing me. I weigh like two... I'm like twice your weight. Nice. That counter. Oh, okay. That counter, damn. This should give me... yeah, blazing. Nice. Do my back one. Woo! That back one is like sound delayed to the point where it doesn't even make sense. Stick a fork in him, he's done. I'm just like, oh yeah. You must be tense after all that fighting. Why don't I give you a rub down? Not with those hot dog fingers. This one's taken. But your corny ass? Nah, I think he's ready for a real woman. Ain't you cute? Come on, baby. Tell the skank what's what. You're about to get your face broken. That's what's what. Bring it on, bitch. Sure. Who weighs more? Sorry. Looks like I'm gonna have to go for the fat one. Whopping 110 pounds. It's gonna be fun. I wanna hear you scream. Okay, there's some psychotic stuff going on here. Sorry, I'm not used to playing somebody that's under 300 pounds, but I'll do my best. I think if you lose this fight, I think you you end up with an ugly girl. Like, you don't end up with either of them. Or is that the second one that I'm thinking of? I can't remember what happens if you lose this fight. Long story short, I know you end up with multiple of these cat fights that you have to go through throughout the game. And you either get to pick new girls to end up with, or you stick with the one that you have, and you unlock galleries where you can look at like model photos of them. It's like the exact kind of thing you'd expect from a early 2000s wrestling game. Just straight up Batman her. I'll pin you while emblazoned. God. I don't think you get money for that, so it doesn't matter how you finish them. The only unique thing there would be, I guess, her blazing move. If you really want to see it. I'm just like, ugh. I always look disgusted. No matter what outcome happens, I'm always disgusted. What the fuck? How come girls never fight over me when I'm out in the club? Seriously though, that was funny as hell. The funniest part about it was watching me just sit there and probably just go deep throat a corn dog on the sidelines while it was happening, because I'm sure that's exactly what I was doing. Okay, but we're in a warehouse. There's no he's growling at me. There's no exclusive anything about this. I like this, what the fuck? This, like, abridged version of, Party Up by DMX playing. Toss him. Okay, like, looking at these two people, there would be a clear winner of this fight, no? Like, I would not stand a chance as, like, a 300-pound frickin' tater tot going up against this dude. Give him that booty smack. He was in midair. What just happened there? He was, like, going for, like, a tornado move. This dude's busting out the anime cookbook. He just watches it. He's just like, this mildly perturbs me. But not enough that I'm going to do anything about it. I will respect your taunting. Toss him. Yeah, Donkey Kong. Okay. It's called batting practice. I just realized that. I have got to be the lamest character on the planet. You keep winning, and my bet should net me enough to pay back my loan and make a little extra on the side. You son of a gun. Razor. Okay, I finally met somebody who's as fat as me, but is he as fast as me? That's the question. You brought the wrong outfit, my guy. We're not boxing. Just break his ankles and put a fist up his butt. Like, seriously, you brought boxing shorts. Like, there should be regulations against that. Okay, he's kicking my ass. He's kicking my ass. Is this gonna be our first loss? Oh. It might be. Did he do his blazing on me? No. Oh my god. Yeah, he fucking won. That was quick, dude. He broke my back. No one can conquer me. See, that's what I'm saying. You can't bring boxing shorts to a wrestling match. That's just unfair. That's just cheating. Okay? Tawsome. I wonder why they respect me when I'm taunting. Like, they always let me finish my taunts, and if they would just interrupt it, they would get a ton of charisma or crowd favor, whatever you want to call it. Not today, Zerg. Stop trying to pick me up. You can't. I'm like 300,000 pounds. I'm going to do my sound delay on you. Your 1-2 sound barrier. There it is. Yo, what's up, Wankster? You think you got the stuff to hit with me? If you want a shot, you better get your ass down here to LeFrac immediately. Etreatedly. Nore, is he, like, infamous for his inability to spell? Or, oh, yep, I changed my outfit. No, I found this shirt in a fucking Dollar Tree. You out of retirement? Oh yeah, he's just helping me out, just these couple of times on account of my money.
You mean my money needs?
Yeah, that's right. Every time he wins, you get paid. It's good for all of us, Steve.
Good for us, but what's he getting out of the deal? Stare all you want, little man. I'm the one making her sweat now.
Gross.
Let's make this quick.
Stop it. Forget about him, baby. He means nothing.
like I were a silent protagonist. It makes us seem even more unhinged. It's just so wild. He's like, stop looking at Atreus, boy. Look at these freaking polyagonal crowd. I see him still just as dumb. I'm sorry, what? Okay, so technically Nore is technically a boss. So we'll see how this goes. Just like Scarface was a boss. He was like an end of chapter. Like, we deal with the four fighters before him, and then we have to deal with him. The Crooklyn Catnap? That's a, oh, somebody who doesn't let me taunt. Look at that. I just realized that the name of that move is the Crooklyn Catnap, and I got caught up in it. Dude, what are you made of? Like, I'm getting hits off on him, but at the same time, like, everything I try to do is like a follow-up, he reversals. Oh man, freaking fell for it. Oh, he did his blazing on me. He just went face first into my gooch. My poor gooch. Sorry, but only my girlfriend, whatever her name is allowed to go face first into my gooch. Smell what I had for frickin' breakfast, dude. Okay, things aren't looking good for you, Nore. There we go. I'm insane. I think that's a win for us. Well, I feel like he was in the air going, ah! Call the ambulance, stick a fork in him, he's got... how many different ways can they get him to say stick a fork in him, he's done? Call an ambulance, he's fucking dead, put a fork in him! Oh, sorry, you lose by 3 pounds today. I gotta find somebody who can match my weight class, okay? That's what this is about. That's right, her name's Deja. I remember now. Yikes! Bam. Time to roll you up. Fruit by the foot. Toss him. Break the bat. I was born on the rooftops. You were merely molded, molded by it. That doesn't do anything in this fight. Not that... Do we need to have a TED talk about vaginal pain? Because I'd rather not. But... I don't think that moveset quite fits in this context. Break the bat! Time to go belongzong. Baloney mode. I'm so stupid. And we'll do blazing. Oh, my God. It was called lap dance, for those of you curious. That dude in the back going ape, he's like, woo! Oh, my God, I have hot dog fingers. What is going on in this game with everyone's hot dogs? DMOP's concept of interest is a little extreme, so I found a way to make more cash. There's a team tournament starting tonight at Da Bridge. Are we going to be playing bridge? Because if that's the case, then let me roll up my sleeves. Tank and Manny versus Zahir and Pee-wee. Pee-wee, I've kicked your ass once, my guy. Why would you come back for seconds? And of course, we got X going to give it to you. Rest in peace.
I'm going to run you into the ground.
I'm going to show you how it's done.
So polite. Well, we get to play as Manny, which sucks. Because he's just obsessed with going ham on people's nuts, apparently. But the way a team battle works is you can basically tap in your teammate whenever you really want. But then your other guy has to leave the arena. The problem with this is that if you start to get low on health, you can actually pull out whoever you're fighting as and save yourself. I think you also don't have to kill both of them. Kill, I say. You don't have to beat both of them. You just have to do your finisher on one of them. And I think the fight ends. He stops. right in front of me. Oh no. Didn't mean to do that. Okay, Manny has got like ass for charisma. Okay, we're all just in here now. I guess that can happen too sometimes. I think they, yeah, so after a certain amount of time, they leave the ring automatically. Okay, Pee-wee's like made of paper at this point. Okay, let's get rid of Pee-wee. Done. That didn't kill him. What the fuck? Why didn't that kill him? Do I have to kill Zaheer? Is that the point of this? I thought you can get rid of either one. I'm thinking more of like multiplayer terms, but maybe that's not how this ends. Oh, maybe it has to be whoever's the active fighter. So yeah, Zaheer. So because Pee-wee is the one who's supposed to be outside the ring right now, technically doing a finisher on him doesn't do anything. God damn, finally. Woo! I had to beat him with a pin. Because Manny's freaking charisma is like the worst. If we can win this tournament, I can finally get D-Mob off my back. Next match is in a week. Sweet. Let's get our defense up there. Oh man. A whole nother group of assholes. I don't even know if I want to fight Moses. He's going to get all biblical on me. That's going to be it for this episode of Let's Sit Down With. If you'd like to see a full series of Def Jam Vendetta, let me know in the comments. Thank you for watching. This has been your host, Pujolino.